Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you very much for providing me this platform to present my paper. My topic is Energy Poverty and Climate Change Mitigation, the Case of Household Sector in India. Climate change is a global problem, and all the countries are going to face the consequences. And it is more acute for the developing countries, because developing countries are more vulnerable to the problem of climate change, and they don't have that much funds also. This problem there is closely related to the growth and development process, because any measure taken for the mitigation of this process may lead to reduction in the GDP, or it can hamper the development process of the economy. And since so many people are under poverty line over there, so it is very difficult to choose the policy option there to tackle the problem of climate change. Here, in a developing country like India, many people are not able to have their basic needs. So we would be very much careful about taking any policy. The fourth assessment report of IPCC states that global warming can have devastating impact on climate of Earth and are capable of affecting the health status of millions of people through increases of malnutrition, disorder in child growth and development, with increased death, disease and injury due to heat waves, floods, storms, fires and drought. All the nations together have to reduce our carbon footprint. India is not an exception. With a considerable stretch of coastal area, India is very much vulnerable to the problem of climate change. It is very much vulnerable to the rise in sea level. Incidents of drought, spells of excessive rain, and accelerated melting of glaciers have already started as an effect of climate change. India is the second most populous country of the world, with population of 1.21 billion. The census 2011 reveals that 66% of households live in rural area, and a major portion of these households are dependent on biomass and fossil fuel for their basic direct energy needs for cooking and lighting. Another problem is that the equipment they use for the purpose of cooking and lighting, that is very much inefficient. That means it takes a lot of energy, and at the same time it is polluting also. And the reason is that the easy availability of fuel wood attracts people to use fuel wood for cooking, which not only leads to environmental degradation, but also huge opportunity cost of collecting fuel wood. And the indoor pollution that leads to the respiratory problem and causes high human health risk. In case of cooking, people normally dependent on fuel wood and kerosene, but in case of lighting, people use kerosene lamps, and that is also another inefficient inefficient equipment. And the alternative is electricity, which is very much, the spread is very much less in India. Till 2010, it is only 89% of households, which 89% of villages are electrified. Still, 10% villages are to be electrified. And use of this inefficient equipment leads to more use of energy, and as well as health problem to the people. So in such a level of poverty and deprivation, the overall development will occur if the growth process becomes more inclusive. This is the idea of Planning Commission over there, and it is here inclusiveness implies fast removal of poverty, generation of employment, and equitable distribution of benefits of growth, and particularly human capability development through education, health, and other basic amenities like clean energy, safe water, etc. This collection of fuel would not only causes health hazard and emission related diseases, but also it hampers the human development, in the sense it mainly women and children collects the fuel load, and that is why they can't participate in work, and it hampers their education level also. So it is the total human development of the country which is getting hampered. So if we get some process to get this get out of this, then it will benefit us economically as well as socially. We can make people more better off. The problem of climate change has been well recognized by all the countries, including India also. IPCC was set up in 1988, and United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change was adopted at Rio Summit in 1992, as we all know. And Kyoto Protocol in 1997 came up with three market-based mechanisms. One is joint implementation, another is clean development mechanism, and a third is emission trading. Here in this paper, I'm considering clean development mechanism. Developed countries can invest in emission reduction mitigation project through CDM in developing countries and can earn certified emission reduction credits. These credits can be used by industrialized countries to meet a part of their emission reduction target under the Kyoto Protocol. So that it will give some financial incentive to the developed countries also, and as well as developing countries. And there is huge level of poverty in the developing countries like India. So it will help people to have their better standard of living. Here in this paper, we try to see the relevance of CDM in household sector of India. To do so, we first discuss the present situation of energy poverty in India. That means the lack of energy we are talking about. The lack of energy is not in terms of the use of primary fuel, but also the physical amount of energy. Because in India, it's not the case that people don't have that access, but even if they have the access, in some cases, like when the village is not electrified, the people can't have access to the electricity. But even if they have the electricity in their village, they can't afford it. So it's very much important to see that aspect also, whether the physical amount is sufficient or not. Additionally, we have seen the total physical amount of different energy carriers used in Indian household for cooking and lighting. It is actually from that total energy amount, we can get that emission, how much it is the households are emitting for direct energy consumption. I have used the NSSO 66 round data for this analysis, and here we get the result that the share of here in the table I have shown share of households using various energy carriers for cooking. Here I have done it in a way that in India there is huge diversity in income classes also. So I have got some income classes. One is less than $0.5 a day. Second is between $0.5 and $1 a day. Third is between $1 and $2 a day. And fourth is more than $2 a day. Here, the percentage of population in an expenditure group we see 43.7% of population actually lives below $0.5 a day, and 45.8% is living between 0.5 and 0.5 and $1 a day. Cumulatively, it comes around 90% of people who are living below $1 a day. And here we can see the percentage of people who are using biomass is for $0.5 a day. I mean, the percentage of people who use biomass as a primary fuel and belongs to the group of below $0.5 a day is 35%. And in the second group, it is 39.7%. So, and cumulatively, it is 82.2% people who are depending on biomass as their primary fuel. Okay, and it is, and for other fuels, it is, we have seen that people have shifted to LPG, but obviously it is very much less. And in case of urban area, it is, people are, 64% of people are now using this LPG. They are moved to more clean fuel. Still 18% of household depend on biomass. And in case of lighting, we have seen that 65% of people are using electricity, but 33% of people are still using kerosene as their primary fuel. In case of lighting in urban area, 93% people are using electricity. So we can say that in urban area, since access is better, so more people are shifting to electricity. And in case of per capita energy consumption for cooking, this is the useful energy consumption. We have seen that it is in the lower income classes, it is quite higher because the use of biomass is quite higher because it is the useful energy. And since it is there is no out of pocket cost, so it is higher for lower income people and comparatively higher for low income people. In case of urban area, we have seen it is quite lower for biomass for lower income people. And in case of lighting, here we see the amount of kerosene and electricity that has been used. And the total consumption of fuels of for cooking and lighting, we have seen the 199 million tons of biomass is used every year. Is used in a year, so it is this huge amount of biomass is consists of the fuel wood and crop residue that comes from the forests. So it leads to considerable forest degradation. And 2018 million liter of kerosene is being used, which is leading to the health hazard and reduction in fossil fuel. So here it is the total energy consumption for lighting, same way. So here I have done the projection of energy poverty. The prevalent energy consumption pattern provided the basis of calculating the estimate of future demand of a particular energy carrier. Per capita expenditure is considered to be the basis of choice of a particular fuel. I have used Logit model. With the current growth rate of GDP, we got the GDP elasticity of PFC. And with this elasticity, I have assumed a 7% growth that concludes 3.9% annual growth of PFC. And with projected population rate of 1.64% by Census of India 2011, we got that still 0.7 million of people in rural household will be using in 2020 will be using the biomass. So it is very important for us to take any policy prescription. I have seen the cost and benefit analysis of introducing CDM in such a case. Till 1st August 2011, 300 CDM projects has been registered, where 858 projects are in India, And here it is the cost benefit analysis. Here I have taken the traditional wood stoves, efficient wood stove, traditional kerosene stoves, and efficient kerosene stoves, and taken the capital cost and annualized capital cost, and the I get the total energy use and the associated energy associated CO2 emissions. For cooking, I have done this for urban area and for rural area, and for lighting, I have done the incandescent bulb, which is of incandescent. I have done it for incandescent bulb and compact fluorescent bulb, and had done this same cost benefit analysis, and we have seen investment and energy saving. If we take the CER price to be $8 per tons of CO2, then what is the net profit at 8% discount rate? And I have done it for cooking and lighting. Here we have found that in a developing country like India, with a large number of population, improvement of energy efficiency can be a useful measure for the reduction of greenhouse gas, and for that we can use CDM. I have done it for individual project, and if it is a project of size 10,000 or more households, the cumulative profit would be higher. And apart from the monetary benefit, it can be said that in socio-economic perspective, it is quite higher. The profit level in cooking it is quite higher. In lighting, it can be if it is done from kerosene to electricity. To compact fluorescent bulb, it will be higher. Okay, thank you.